How can we stop Putin from resorting to nuclear warfare? Hello, I'm Steve Forbes, and this is What's Ahead, where you get the insights you need to better navigate these turbulent times. Putin and other Russian officials have been warning that Moscow may use nuclear weapons in Ukraine. Unthinkable? Horrifyingly, less so. Putin grossly miscalculated this war. He was oblivious to the rot his and his government's massive corruption had infected the military. Officers and government defense officials were too busy padding their pockets to do the hard work of building a modern army. The opposite was true of Ukraine. Its army was badly beaten in 2014 when Putin seized Crimea and started occupying parts of eastern Ukraine with special Russian forces and local separatist militias. But from that defeat, Ukraine radically reformed its military. The U.S., Britain, and others sent military officials to train Ukrainian forces in sophisticated modern warfare. This, combined with hard combat experience from the simmering, ongoing war since 2014, made Ukraine's military one of the best in the world. If Ukraine had been given all the military hardware and ammunition it needed weeks ago, it would have already expelled the Russian invaders. Even now, this battered but unbeaten land is still not receiving all it needs. Nonetheless, Putin faces humiliation. His eastern offensive gains ground, but at an immense cost. He's not winning. This Monday, May 9, Russia will mark the anniversary of the defeat of Nazi Germany, and Putin clearly wants a trophy to celebrate his Ukrainian invasion. He probably won't go to nuclear war before then, but Putin knows his dream of a new Russian empire that dominates Eastern and Central Europe and holds Western Europe in fear of Moscow is in dire jeopardy. He may well conclude the only way he can salvage the massive mess he finds himself in now is to explode a low-yield nuclear device, which would have one-third of the explosive power of the bomb we dropped in Hiroshima in 1945 on either a Ukrainian city or in a rural area as a demonstration of his determination to win. How to deter him? Make abundantly clear that NATO will obliterate all Russian forces in and near Ukraine. We have the power to do that. All Russian exports of oil and gas, which are still taking place, would be immediately stopped. All Russian bank assets would be frozen, which act has not yet been done. The critical Black Sea would be blockaded. All Russian naval vessels there would be seized or sunk. We would launch the mother of all cyber attacks and much, much more. It would be costly, but the Russian economy would quickly collapse and Russia would not get Ukraine. If these and other moves are credibly threatened, Russian generals and officials will probably move on Putin. Most don't want to go down with this sick, deluded dictator. Hopefully, Washington and NATO are seriously contemplating how to prevent the taboo on nukes that has been in effect since 1945 from being broken. The stakes are immeasurable. I'm Steve Forbes. Thanks for listening. Send in your comments and suggestions. I look forward to being with you soon again.